Hello, and thank you for joining. A warm welcome to day 8 of our Fair Africa Fortnight campaign that we have themed Buy Local, Build Africa. The purpose of this campaign is to highlight the positive impact that local business has on our economy and how we as consumers can help change the socio-economic status of our countries by supporting locally, ethically, and fairly trading businesses. This morning, we hear from Benoit Berger, Vice Chairman of the WFTO Africa and Middle East Board and a member of the Fair Trade Towns Board. He defines and describes the value presented by the Fair Trade Towns model. We also hear from Alderman Conrad Poole, Executive Mayor of Draglity, as he takes us through how they implemented the Fair Trade Towns campaign and the value they anticipate the campaign to contribute to their municipal processes. Please remember to register now for our first ever virtual walkathon themed Strides for Africa on the 2nd of October. Add your voice in the cause to support local businesses and build African economies. Enjoy.
To become a fair trade city means that the municipality declaring itself as an advocate for sustainability, and it will put sustainability issues forward in the agenda, and issues like your war on waste and Drakenstein municipality against gender-based violence. The steps to get a fair trade status is that the local municipality, the council, has passed a resolution supporting the fair trade by agreeing that they will make sure that the local fair trade are sustainable.
In December 2020, Drakenstein Council took a decision to declare itself as a fair trade city. This means the municipality supports goods produced using fair labor practices and production processes that do not harm the environment. The municipality supports environmentally friendly, sustainable and locally produced goods.
Daar moet kos in die huis wees, so daar's altyd werk. So as natuurlik as my besigheid vergroot, dan moet ek meer mense aanskaf om vir my te help.
It is a challenge to be sustainable, even though the entire world is focusing on sustainability. For some reason, packaging isn't there yet. So it's so important to, in whatever is possible. So that's our point of view in everything we do. We are 22 staff, which 19 are ladies, and the majority of all of our staff are under 35.
Ons het 'n premie gekry. Volgens elke wynbottel wat ons verkoop het, wit en rooi, daardie geld stroom in en het kom in en ons begroot dit as Fair Trade Premie Komitee. Die sociale projekte wat ons het op die plaas om die gemeenskap te bemagtig is die kleuterskool wat ons bedryf en dan is het die naskool en dan is het ons jeugdprogramme en dan het ons die vervoerstelsel. Ons het 1-2 quantum bussies, die een het ons nou verkoop, maar ons het nou tans begroot vir nog een.
By supporting the Fair Trade Initiative, you are proactively supporting sustainable development of our city. Clean air, pristine natural beauty, healthy communities and businesses that can survive hardships.
Feel free to come and join us. And it will be nice to have you on board to be part of our Fair Trade initiatives. I thank you.
Hello, I am Benoit Berger from Fair Trade Lebanon, and I am very happy to be with you for this Fair Africa Fortnight 2021. I am the Vice Chair of the WFTO Africa and Middle East, and I am also sitting at the International Fair Trade Town Steering Committee representing the region Africa and Middle East. So I would like to seize this opportunity of this Africa Fortnight to introduce to you the concept of Fair Trade Town and to see together how we can adapt it and implement it in our region. Historically, Fair Trade Town is a concept that has been established in the northern country, so we may say consumer countries such as England, United Kingdom, or France, Germany. The first Fair Trade Town was Castong in the west of England. In 2020, this small city decided to declare itself as a Fair Trade Town by promoting the consumption of Fair Trade products on its territory. The important thing with the Fair Trade Town is that the local authorities, the municipality, the chair of the municipality especially, are involved to promote this concept of Fair Trade certified products consumption. With the time, this approach of promoting Fair Trade product consumption has been enlarged to awareness raising, to education, to, for example, inviting Fair Trade producers from different countries, and to organizing campaigns during all the year, and especially during the World Fair Trade Day celebration, to promote the concept of Fair Trade in the community. So this approach is not a certification approach. It's a way to raise awareness and to have a community declaring itself as Fair Trade according to some principles that are in the Fair Trade concept altogether. So I think this is an opportunity to duplicate this model of Fair Trade communities, Fair Trade towns in other countries of our region. As you know, Fair Trade is a moving environment, it's a moving concept. We can see more and more short value chain in the northern countries that declare themselves as Fair Trade. That means that all the community will engage in fair approach with his neighborhood and with the neighbor producers, with the neighbor artisans that are present on the territory. And most important, we should have an authority, a local authority, which declare clearly through a statement, through press releases, for example, that they are engaged, they are committed to develop these fair principles in all the territory for all the businesses that are active on the territory. So being a Fair Trade Town is a way to be involved in the global movement, is a way to connect with other Fair Trade Towns in the world, is a way to establish network of campaigns, network of actors that will be mobilized together according to same values. Hopefully, when a Fair Trade Town will be established in your country, in Africa, you may connect with other Fair Trade Town in Europe, and this will develop access to new markets. But I would say this is not the initial objective of being a Fair Trade Town. The initial objective is really to create a spirit on the local level and to be engaged as a local authority to promote Fair Trade Town with your producers and your consumers. We are also working on duplicating the experience of Fair Trade universities or Fair Trade schools that has been launched in other countries in Europe, in North America, and to see how we can adapt this model to our region. So I think we are really at the beginning of a journey together, connecting our campaigns And I think we should first connect at the level of the region between South Africa, North Africa, Middle East, to see how we can learn from each other of our experience. Also, a good news is that Turkey is entering the fair trade planet, I would say. It's a new country in our region, and they're also implementing the concept of fair trade town for the city of Izmir, which is a huge city in Turkey. So I think all those experiences in our region would be very inspiring to connect and to also be part of the global movement of fair trade communities, not only to increase the consumption of fair trade products, but also to increase the awareness of communities that are not usually involved in the fair trade value chains. They are not producers, they are perhaps not consumers so far, but they may become students in schools, students in the universities, and through those campaigns, awareness campaigns, they may join the global movement. So thank you for listening to this small video, and I wish you a great success in the Fair Africa Fortnight 2021.